So the sun, looking here from the ground, seems very constant and quiet. But actually, when we look at it from space, we can see it's quite turbulent and active. Space weather is activity on the sun and in the near-Earth space that can affect our technological infrastructure and society. The sun is constantly spewing out a stream of particles called the solar wind that goes out into the solar system. And it affects us here near Earth, where we're protected by a magnetic field. The interaction between the solar wind and the magnetic field can cause space weather. The Carrington event is the largest storm we've seen in recorded history when we're looking at space weather. But every solar cycle, which repeats about every 11 years, one estimates that there's a 10% chance of getting a large storm like the Carrington event that could impact us here on Earth. But we see solar storms almost all the time. And these storms have an effect on our technological infrastructure. Solar storms can cause activity in Earth's atmosphere and magnetosphere that can damage electrical power grids that power our communities, interrupt radio and satellite communications, and can cause our GPS navigation to fail. NOAA is working with its international partners to ensure that we have different vantage points where we can observe space weather. Our space weather observing infrastructure from space includes the NOAA Discover satellite, and the NASA ACE satellite that are stationed upstream of Earth to give us a first buoy measurement of the solar wind. It also includes the ESA-NASA SOHO satellite and the NASA STEREO satellite that image the sun and also make coronagraph measurements of the outer atmosphere of the sun, the corona, that can tell us when large explosions happen off the sun. We also observe the sun and the Earth's magnetic field from the geostationary location with NOAA's GOES. So the way we use the space weather information from satellites and from the ground is to be able to make forecasts and predictions, just like we do with hurricanes and terrestrial weather. We observe the sun and look for activity and see how it develops, and see if it's going to culminate into a large explosion that can affect us here on Earth. NOAA is working with its international partners to expand our observing capability. We're committed to observing along the Sun-Earth line. So we're going to do the imaging of the sun and the upstream buoy measurements of the solar wind along the Sun-Earth axis. The more we understand about the sun, the more we can prepare for it and become, just like we are a weather-ready nation, become a space weather-ready nation. And as we look forward to humans exploring out into the solar system and advancing our space commerce activities, space weather becomes more and more important.